Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. Wanted to spend a moment and talking just a little bit about the MIL-STD-810. And today we're talking about method 519, which is gunfire. And in the gunfire method, you're really looking at applications where you might have guns mounted on aircraft or other systems, and you're trying to really create do some testing that verifies that your electronics or an electronics packaging can withstand anything from, say, a 50 cal or a 20 millimeter gun to, say, a 30 millimeter gun, and it could be a Gatling gun or it could be just a machine gun of some kind. Crystal Group has a couple of applications where we actually have servers mounted in gun pods, and so that became important for us to make sure that we could withstand that vibration because of the shock pulse, the muzzle blast, as well as the random vibration associated with the aircraft engines, as well as the blade and its resonant frequencies and harmonics. And so what we did was we had to go in and do vibration testing to verify that that was not going to be a problem. Typically, the application will require a certain test method, and there are four different procedures that you need to choose from. Generally, those will be chosen for you, but in effect, you're looking at different approaches to doing the testing. And one of the things that we've learned is always do the endurance testing first, because once you get through that, essentially, you'll be able to pass the operational testing. And so there are four different test methods, as I mentioned earlier, and each one of these test methods really are, it's the method in which it's conducted that is a little bit different. Some of them use an RMS value for the vibration, and then there's pulses over the top on that. Sometimes they use random on sign, and so there's a bunch of different types of testing that you can do, and it gets a little complicated in the fact that the instrumentation, the calibration, even the analysis of the data frequently involves a lot of effort associated with trying to understand what's going on and are you duplicating the environment, getting through that kind of testing is a challenge sometimes, and so we're really kind of looking for what damage from the fatigue standpoint, what damage from electronics, what damage is there from glass types of components or brittle fractures within the system. So you're looking at a variety of different effects that gunfire and that blast, that muzzle blast, does to your product as it's being exercised on that platform, whatever that platform may be. It could be a fighter, could be a small weapons platform, a helicopter, whatever it is. So that presents a challenge. I'm not going to say it's an interesting read for the spec, because it's quite lengthy. There's some higher level math, Fourier series, Fourier transforms in there. So the reason that you really want to have a handle on this is so that your equipment can be tested to withstand the extremes associated with that type of gunfire or that type of random vibration that you might experience on one of those platforms. So it does become important to make sure that you have a reliable, highly available system for that particular platform. I hope that helps.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.